All right, Rich, how you doing, mate? You're in the background there.
Hey, what's up?
Yo.
I thought Bill was about to drop something.
Yeah, I'm trying to keep up. I'm just going to put you on the screen with voice so it looks a bit more interactive. I'll just broadcast you. That was interesting, though. Those guys, I mean, they're promoting nothing. There's nothing there that they can promote, you know? And it's kind of like they're just promoting a blue website.
Not even a step in the right direction more than what they just tried with Boomerang.
Well, nothing. They're promoting just a platform that you sign up and
they get. They didn't even describe the product. They just described, like, you get a 2X, a 3X, you get a 4X, but you get a 3X, and then put your money in, and then you get this. It's like, that doesn't mean anything. Why can't they just show something for real already?
Well, why don't they teach people to be entrepreneurial? You know, how to run a business. I mean, maybe that's what we need to start doing. Is like, I've got a person at the moment who wants to start up a drop shipping business, and they've been talking to me for friggin' ages. And I'm going, come on, make a decision and do something. I mean, starting a business and starting a new venture of some sort isn't actually rocket science. It's not that hard to do. I just think people sometimes need to take a bit of a leap of faith. And also, if you think that you can start a business and make a profit straight away, you've got you're brain dead. You've got to start small and think big. So you've got to come up with an idea, concept, something that you're passionate about, and try to figure out how to make money.
Exactly.
And when you do that, then see if you can replicate it and make sure you get your pricing right.
Yep.
It's not that hard. Well, it is that hard, but it isn't.
Becomes your own wisdom. Like you take a sample of what you just described, the first step of what you can do, and you get it right, and then you show yourself that you know how to get it right, and then you go look for that same progress somewhere else and be like, oh, okay, I can compare that with this.
Yep.
But with these scams, they never show like how would they present this to an audience and not be able to say, this is who I am based off of what I've pulled together, the first 10 steps of what I'm showing you. Like, we came up with this one-off. But they know full well that they didn't come up with their one-off. They've been replicating it over and over and over and over for freaking years. And they're never going to admit that to nobody. So it's like, why can't we just get in there and show these people that that's where the problem is? That's how you catch these scammers in the lie. Like, so I'm trying this Crime Stoppers thing.
Oh, yeah.
Right now I just filled out half the form. I'm looking for the California link to put in there with the description.
Oh, yeah.
And if we create the certain awareness where people know that this scam exists, but then we show people how to go and do proper real due diligence, then we just completely alleviated everything, the whole problem, the whole nutshell. And then you can do, like you said, start showing people how to do real entrepreneurs.
Yeah. I think the generation that we have is quite sad. We think that we can put our money into something and do nothing and get high returns. I mean, how the hell does that, you know, it's just, It is actually,
and it keeps like, babe, and it keeps like not replicating, but it keeps like spawning another form, another freaking engrossed vision of, oh, we're gonna have, like you say, a high return, but you don't even have nothing yet.
Yeah, I was trying to ring that.
How do I find that California link real quick?
Now, what's it called?
The California cease and desist order link.
Oh, yep, I'll find it. I'll send it to you on where are you hiding here?
I put today's Chavez video.
Oh, did you?
You just put it in there for me. Never mind.
Oh, okay. Thanks. Susie, are you like poised on the end of the keyboard sitting there waiting for
Can she hear us?
Yeah, no, everyone can hear us, mate. We're live.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know we're still live. I thought you said you cut it.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm trying to record things in segments so I can chop them up like I did yesterday.
Yeah. Oh, perfect. So what I was saying for our segment wise is it's simple. People know how to teach, you know, 6th, 7th, 8th graders how to type on a computer. They can make themselves look and sound like a Susie Sue, right?
Yep.
But you can literally get a job typing at the school. You can literally get paid to do a job typing. But if the people growing up today have never heard of this, if they don't know of elderly abuse until they see it firsthand, how are they going to know that this stuff is existing in the way that it is, continuously replicating, duplicating itself like this?
Yeah.
So it's awareness. It's always going to be awareness, because 2 years from now, somebody's going to be trying something even more scummier, more scammier.
Yeah, and with the use of, you know, like, technology is our best friend and our worst nightmare all in one go, really. So it's like, you know, like AI is going to be interesting. I mean, like, I just searched for that, I just searched ChatGPT to find out whether that CEO of that company is actually legit. The only information I got was just like you the other day. It came from his own company. So people are going to know how to spoof the results of ChatGPT information in the not too distant future. So then they'll be, next thing they'll be in these meetings going, oh, go to ChatGPT and search for me and find out what you find. I've got nothing on me. But they know they've created a fake name and then done a few articles on a few prominent blogs where ChatGPT gets his information from, and, you know, and that's how they build authenticity. So that'll be the next round of saying, oh, I'm, you know, even that LinkedIn profile I just had a look at there, you know, I can see, you know, it could be a genuine guy, but then we'll find that somebody lost access to their LinkedIn account and they can't get it back. And they, you know, you just don't know, really.
They have a link for live chat.
Oh, yeah.
Let me click on this.
Actually, I've just got talk to somebody. A link from Bob, another Zoom meeting. Are you kidding me? Is he? Who's he got? Luke. I always freak out when I get links from Bob. Because you never know what you're going to click on or what you're going to stumble across. I don't know how he defines him, but must be in every Telegram. I presume that the link password for this one is, remember, this meeting is weekly. What's the password for that one, Bob?
Oh, this is cool, dude. It connected me to Chicago Police Department.
Ooh.
It says it's not a, it does not constitute a police report, but your information will be reviewed and forwarded to the most appropriate law enforcement agency. So we can tell people, it goes by city and state. You can literally click on wherever you want to click on in the country.
Oh, yeah.
And then it'll give you this two-way conversation back and forth. This is cool. And it also says Australia, Central America, Latin America. It's not just America.
Oh, and just because I went quite listening, what's it called again? Something was
Crime Stoppers.
Crime Stoppers.
I'll put the link in the chat.
Oh, yeah, that's great. Crime Stoppers, Mavi Global. Oh, my God. Oh, my goodness. So we found Mavi Global's. God, how did you find that one? That's a goodie. So we've just found the Zoom room for Mavi Global. And what did Bob say? Remember, his meeting up weekly. I can't quite read you. Record him and scare the shit out of him.
Yeah.
God. Oh, that's great.
David?
No, this is.
Which David is it?
What are you talking about? No, it's Bob.
Yeah, but which David are you guys talking about?
Well, I don't know.
Oh.
But there was a link in Bob's Telegram, WhatsApp group to their Zoom meeting.
Yeah.
And I've just gone in there and it's, oh, Marvel Global, cool. So this is when we kicked Carl Harveston yesterday. He was promoting Marvel.
No.
But Marvel's now being flagged by California as running a scam. Their government. So the fact that they've still got meetings happening or theoretically happening is quite breathtaking. It's just like when Woz got flagged as a cease and desist, people then, Jarvis gets up there and adds a line of code to the terms and conditions and says, Sam is no longer here, but I'm the new CEO. We're not running a scam. You know, I mean, what the heck? You just can't believe that shit, can you? So that's quite good. That made sense, but yeah. Marvel Google. So yeah, it's interesting. Now it's 10 o'clock, and what day is it? It's Tuesday. So we asked Satoshi, we'll probably try running another meeting in a few minutes.
Yeah.
Crazy.
That's what I thought Bill was going to do, is pop that in there.
If anyone knows the link to Crypto Man's Zoom meeting, I would appreciate it. I'm just trying to get into a few now. Delete. We've got the Island Girls. I'm just going to go through a few while we're having a yarn to you. And you're having a few days off, are you, by the sound of it? Is your truck fixed?
No, man. Freaking truck is in the shop till tomorrow.
Oh, right. I sat down in the car, had it running last night, and I blinked, and half an hour went by in my life that I never got back again, because I just nodded off while I'm sitting in the car in the car park.
That's how I was when I had to take a Lyft ride back up here. I felt like I was going to throw up.
Oh, yeah.
Because I can't ride in the back seat after showing
up. Yeah. And why is that? Oh, because of the we're in the we've just got into a link meeting. All right. G'day guys, how you doing? Present. Are you there, guys? Hello. How you doing? G'day, guys. How you doing? I love the costume, man. Those that looks awesome, man. This is the island room, isn't it? Can you hear me okay? I was just sitting there. The avatar's looking at me going, hello, Danny. How are you? Hello, Danny. My old friend. I'm not very good at singing. I'm in the island room at the moment. They're looking at me. I'll show yourself you. Turn my camera on. Say good day. How you going, guys? Nice to see you here. Can you hear me okay? How do you feel about the launch today with Boomerang? Remember, Sharvis said that he's going to do a demo of the arbitrage trading bot. We had got up at 6 o'clock in the morning hoping to see a demo, and nothing happened once again. It must be quite disappointing that you guys are promoting it and it's taken over 100 days and there's been no launch, not even a demo. Would like to take control of you. Well, you can take control of my camera. That's not a problem. I want to take control of my camera. How you going, guys? Have we got no sound? Let's see if we can get the sound back. Default sound. Oh, maybe if I go Zoom. Does that work? Oh, they put me on mute. The host is not allowed. Host will not allow people to unmute themselves. Here we go. No, they're trying to block my sound, but they can't turn my camera off. Isn't that crazy? So I'm sitting in here in a room with the Island Girls. Where's Bob? I wonder if Bob wants to come in. Can we get some visitors into your room? We'll get some visitors in here if you want. Anyone want to go in and visit the Island Girls? Here's the Zoom link. They like visitors. I'll probably have to lock the meeting after we've been in here. So let me get this right. I don't think you guys have got admin control. Is that right? And I'm in here and you can't kick me out, but the only thing you can do is mute me. Let's have a look. There's no host. Oh, there is a host. Oh, and she's not here. Oh, no, you are there. Well, why can't you unmute me? Let's unmute me. Cannot unmute yourself. But you can't kick me out? Am I stuck in your Zoom? That must be embarrassing. Let's have a look here. Add a pin. You have to ring up, what's the Island Girl's name who was doing the weightlifting? I'll give you guys a love heart. There you go. There, love heart. There you go. Raise my hand. Can I speak? Settings. The things I do to entertain myself. Maybe we use a different camera. Anyone else want to come in here? What was the other meeting like? You're talking about Dumb and Dumber. Come in here, Rob. Say good day for a sec. I'm just in, I'm stuck in the island room. I can't get out. They can't kick me out, I think, but they can't. They've blocked my microphone, so I can't talk. But they've got this reggae guy here. Reggae man. Anyway, what we'll do, we'll leave him in there and we'll come back and I'll go off looking for some other rooms to go into. Nandy's room. Did you should we ring up Nandy? Nandy's the lady that's been promoting Sam Lee stuff. We'll give her a ring, eh? There we go. Ring her up. See how she is. Nandy? Okay, Nandy.
Yeah?
Yeah, how you doing? It's Danny DeHeck. You may have heard of me. Oh, I was associated with Sam Lee. I know you're associated with Sam Lee.
Oh, I don't even know Sam Lee.
And you've been doing Vend productions. Oh, she doesn't know Sam Lee, but she's left. Okay, guys, do you know that lady? Nandy? Nandy?
Yeah?
Yeah, how you doing? It's Danny DeHeck. You may have heard of me. We're just doing
no,
some...
No, I'm not playing with you.
Oh, I haven't? Okay, guys, that's a recording of Nandy, who was promoting Sam Lee's products. And I rang her up the other day and got a phone call, and she claims that she doesn't know who Sam Lee is, nor does she know who I am, which is, I thought was quite interesting. But I thought that might be interesting to you guys, because you are promoting We Are All Satoshi. And you've told me to unmute my microphone, which is quite interesting. I just need to change the battery in my camera. So I'm sort of wondering what you guys are actually, where you are at promoting Boomerang and We Are All Satoshi, because it must be kind of like getting a bit embarrassing, the fact that they have not launched. Do you guys have a spokesman that you could sort of like perhaps give me some information on, or some information on why they haven't launched for over 100 days? And what happened today? They were meant to have a launch today, weren't they? A live demo. And I even got like a fancy Nancy image made up last night, ready for the live demo, and then nothing happened. That was kind of embarrassing. Hopefully my camera will be back. There we go. Oh, no, still gonna flip this camera off. So you guys can hear me, but I can't hear you. And you've got control of my camera because I let you, and still no words. Are you like, are you an avatar? Can we, hello, how are you, avatar? I love the hairdo. Pretty cool, isn't it? Look at that. No Streamlabs link. Oh, did I not do that today? It should be at the top, Rob. We're just having a wee yarn in the. There we go, Rob. What am I thinking? Now, there must be a Streamlabs link. You just don't know how to use the computer, mate. That's the problem. Yeah, so this is the Island Girls. Quite cool. And they've unmuted my mic. I always like playing a wee message for them. I think this one here is quite good. I know who you are. I know what you have done. And if you're thinking of escaping with people's investments, I can assure you there's nowhere you can hide. Nowhere.
What I possess is a specific set of skills honed over a lifetime of unraveling financial deceit. Skills that make me a living nightmare for fraudsters like you. If you return the investments now, that will be the end of it.
No, I won't really.
I won't pursue you.
No, I probably will.
I won't track you down.
I will.
But if you choose not to, I will find you. I will expose you. And I will assure you face the full force of this individual. I know.
Yeah, that's a problem I got. It keeps repeating itself. All right, guys, as much as I love you guys, I'll leave the Zoom open, but I've got my mate here, and my mate here, Rob here, and I'm going to do a little wee intro here, Rob. Just hold five there before you get and even open your mouth, really.
Good afternoon. Danny DeHeck, a.k.a. the Crypto Ponzi Scheme Avenger. Welcome to Avenger News. Rob Woolley and myself are going to do a little bit of a catch-up on actually what went down last night, or this morning, if you're in New Zealand, with Boomerang and with this other new system. Rob wants a bit of a catch-up on what's happening. Rob, welcome to the Avenger News. How are you doing today, my friend?
I'm doing very good. I was going to call you Sam.
Really? God, I thought Sir... Sir was going to come out of your mouth, and I thought, oh, surely this is going to be good. But no, he didn't even say that.
I'm so glad I watched Chavez's presentation.
Did you get a ton of information out of that? Did you hear him say that he's going to launch in 7 days? Did you tickle your underarm and your belly when you heard that and thought, oh my goodness, I'm going to have a field day with that? And how many times have we heard him say that? We were going to launch, however, the swimming pool didn't have any water in it, so we had to fill it up, and we're so far looking for a water tanker. That sort of style, isn't it?
Mate, I jotted some notes down.
Did you? Did you bring anything?
The overwhelming thing is, thank God I'm not listening to this bullshit every day.
I got told to shut up by a guy. What's his name? I forget. He's just a small-time country boy. Because he said I was over-talking the thing, and he said, shut up, I can't hear him, Admiral. Like, you don't talk to admirals like that. Do you not know who I am? But yeah, that was funny.
Yes, kidding. You do need to shut up.
Somebody had to. Somebody had to tell you.
Oh, but I was listening to it and I go, I can't help
it's
but
it's only
say
the
stuff.
Little bits. It's only the short bits when Chavez was talking. It's not hard, well, Admiral.
Are you waiting for him to say something intelligent?
I'm not too sure who he's waiting for, but look, in all honesty, when I was streaming those, just shut up, because everybody is tuned in for Chavez. And the problem is that if you're talking, you can't listen and talk at the same time. And it'll be those little things that you can pick up on, but you've got to say, I'm here to listen. And just take your notes down, because that's what I used to do, and I think I used to get a lot more out of it. Because I've been watching your videos sometimes, and there'll be trashy in the back talking about something, and you go, Danny, shut up, I can't hear it, I can't be bothered going in the back room.
You guys need to log into the Zoom meeting and get your wee notebooks out. I mean, this is the crypto Ponzi schemer event.
Thing is, if we're going to grab it afterwards, if we're going to grab the clip afterwards, ideally we want a clean clip to use, don't we? So
I was amazed they actually broadcasted it, didn't they? They broadcasted it live today, which is unusual.
Yeah, and they had 2,200 people watching that live at the time that I zoomed into it.
Really?
You know,
no way.
Doesn't that tell you something that is good, though? Because if we've been on the tail of this since day one, and if, let's say, they do get traction, we've watched from birth, it was a conception to birth, whatever it is, and now we're watching it grow up. And it's actually quite eye-watering to want that. But, you know, like, and if he's going to Vietnam, he knows, you know, like, we've already seen a Zoom meeting packed out with 1,000 people to that guy, Simon Lee, who was promoting OneCoin. Now, why would Chavez be flying to Vietnam?
He had 42,000 members.
Yeah.
Didn't he? That's what he said. He had 40,000.
Hold on, Crypto G.
Hold your horses. Here we go.
Danny, where did Crypto G get that figure from?
Yeah, I know that. But that wasn't even from the same guy.
No. Yeah, where did he get it from?
Well, yeah, I know. He got it from the meeting. He's regurgitating. It was not verified. He got it from the other meeting. He fell victim to the propaganda.
He listened. Next will be,
yeah. Well, I heard it as well.
Not
well,
closely enough.
No, I was looking at the guy's face and going, you're not Simon Lee.
I'm pretty sure he would have heard that on the meeting.
But there was not Simon Lee in there. So there was another guy who claims he's got a team in Vietnam. So there must be two of them. You know,
well, there's probably only two people, really.
My bloody team has got 10 people in it. I don't know how to promote. I should go to one of those scammer guys and go, hey, can you get some more people to sign up as Avengers? You must have a few disgruntled customers. Can I look after them?
I reckon if they have a big presentation over in Vietnam, like, is it Ho Chi Minh City or Hanoi or wherever? Right. Yeah, you know, like, we'll hire a little marquee in the corner. You know, like, Avengers sign up here.
It's called Ho Chi Minh City now. I'm not saying it right, but it used to, Saigon. It used to be called Saigon. That's right. I was going to say it used to be called. I'm bloody cold. I'm just going to hug the heater.
Is he safe going there?
I know exactly what I was thinking. He'll get arrested and molested.
How do you know he's going there? You know, like, this is the whole thing. Like, he said he's going there, but is he going there? And like, 42,000 people. Because it's like, when I heard that, I thought 42,000 people. You signed up, what, supposedly 86,500 people on licenses. What, but what, 47% of them all came from Vietnam? Or have those people just joined the team and not bought a license?
Well, I don't know.
I'll put it in writing for you later, Denny.
That's right. Oh, no, Richard sent me a video of some guy. Oh, my God, that's good. Hold it. We've got to watch this, guys. I want to see if I can bring this one up. It's quite exciting.
It's another naked trucker.
No. This is exactly what Sharvis needs when he turns up. Share screen. Make sure I get this right. Don't think it's got any sound to it. I'll turn the sound off just in case. There we go. Can you guys see that? Okay. What? Okay. So the guy standing there, he's talking about boomerang. Boomerang's the best thing ever, man. Sign up, get your licenses. And then Richard comes along.
Shit. That's the Pacific Island woman getting Danny DeHeck out of there.
Yeah, that's Customs 101, man. That was quite exciting. There you go, Richard. You did good there. You shared something good while I'm, you know, in a meeting. I managed to bring it up. It's got no sound. I mean, good job. Hey, Danny. Donald Trump today. Hey, oh, my Danny. God. Oh, hold it. Hold it. We got that.
Danny.
I did by myself the other day. I've even got that Danny. I did one like that myself. That Danny.
Did he not see him coming though? Surely he would have had a little bit of a sidestep.
Well, mate, there was a 4.3 earthquake for the few seconds. This guy's running across the room.
Oh, he's all dressed up as well.
The size of him.
Wonder if it does have sound.
That yeah, but he's a big boy. It would have taken him a while to get moving.
Let's see what he's going to sound.
Too cocky, you see.
Oh, I've got to turn the sound on now. Oh, let's see if we can do the sound. I want to see now. Now I have to turn the sound on because I can't help myself. So we'll go like, we're going to share the screen, present the screen, click the screen, pick the clip, turn the sound on, and then hopefully...
I mean, if he'd stepped sideways and the guy had gone head first through the door, that would have been even funnier, wouldn't it?
No, you got to hurt it for me, man.
No, I think I got to leave him.
Yeah, you'll leave me hanging down like
that. I'm going to leave you hanging.
No, you got to hurt it for me, man.
No, I think I got to leave him.
Yeah, you'll leave me hanging down like that.
I'm
going to
leave you hanging.
Wow. What is he saying? You got a, I think you got a hug for me, man. I got a hug for you, man.
Yeah,
I miss you, Doug.
Yeah, well, that was exciting, wasn't it?
Have you seen that one where the guy jumps out? I was gonna send that clip to you. I think I probably forgot. Over the courtroom, launches himself over the courtroom and starts strangling the judge, it's a female.
Is that wrong?
Judge, and
it's,
I thought
there's not enough of
that one.
Sharvis,
if I can dig it out for you, you might be able to use that one.
Oh, Richard's trying to sleep.
Homeless wanted a place I'd live for the night.
Richard's trying to. Richard's trying to fill out a form, and the form's asked for the scammer's address. He's just asked for
100 Boomerang Lane.
Yes, right. Floor 1,000,001.
It's a waste of time mailing him something, Richard, because it's just going to come back.
Why are you guys watching my video?
Oh, mate, we haven't got 400 years, mate. You've got quite a few videos out there. Any specific video you want to watch?
Yeah, the video where I was tackling the guy.
Oh, my God.
Well, that was not you, mate. We couldn't see your shoes. Can't
that was me.
Yeah, size 10 and a half, mate. We've narrowed you down now. Got here, size 10 and a half.
Here we go.
American.
I knew Crypto G was a shoe salesman.
I think.
Just to stroke my ego, did you enjoy my podcast? Not the one last night, because we know you enjoyed that. He's not listening, is he? That's a problem. No.
Wait to meet Bob, because we actually think he's about a 300-pound transsexual who's from Alabama but moved to New York and spent some time in Canada.
He didn't have kinky boots on. He didn't have kinky boots on.
Did you track the smart address?
Oh, I did actually. I figured that out after you'd done it. I did it backwards, but that's the smart contract address for the bull suckers, isn't it?
For only $1,200, you could get your own nod.
$1,000
That's what I know.
Well, I might be interested in that. So we can bring that up.
There's only 9,999 coins.
Sorry, is this a sales pitch? I think it might be a sales pitch.
I read that. What was that in Bob?
X Bull Run.
Ah, God.
Let's see. Well, I brought it up here. So what am I looking at? I'm looking at, I had to go to my tag. I'm so grateful. So when they said that they're going to try to, oh, we've got to talk about something really big here. They said that Chavez is hell-bent at trying to hide everything on the blockchain. And he was quite chuckled. He's dropping hints that he reckons he's going to be able to hide everything. How do you feel? That's pretty amazing, isn't it? That he thinks he can hide shit. What's it called? Bull Run, isn't it? Bull run. I mean,
so well, if you have Carlo as your advisor and Joe, good luck.
Yeah.
So what these contracts Mike look and at, Mike are you on about?
Oh, Mike and Mike. Oh, they're doing another arbitrage thing, and that's why they didn't like that I was in the room saying, hey, what happened to Boomerang? And there's another guy in there saying, hey, what happened to the other ones in 2022 that you guys pitched us?
Exactly. They came out of retirement, didn't they? I'm sure I remember hearing them say they came out of retirement.
Yeah, they said that about so Boomerang. They said that we came out of retirement to promote Boomerang.
Yeah.
And that when you look at their Vimeo account, it has Daisy. It has there's another old one on there. I think they promoted C and Bull at one point. So,
Richard,
that's how Chavez is going to get taken down. We're going to pull it like that.
Richard's got these like, is this guy that just tackles everyone?
I think Richard has got a fetish going on.
Oh, mate, take right, him
down. That's going to be us. We're going to pull up. Rob's gonna distract him. Like, right. I'll just be the guy, normal guy walking down the street, and I'll tackle him because wow, they won't know what I look like.
Oh my god, this is like a whole YouTube channel dedicated. I want to do the pool one. That looks fun.
Mate, he got a million views. One of those.
Well, I might start doing this. Oh, that's a good one.
Well, it's better than what you're doing, Danny.
Well, I mean, a whole YouTube channel.
Man, I can be the dancing guy outside the pool.
Well, maybe I need to change my tactics. I mean, maybe I need
you need to walk down Papanui Road and crash tackle all the 14-year-old kids that are walking around outside shops.
It's a bit unfair. He's padded up and he's like an elephant. He's, you know.
Oh.
Yeah. But I mean, that's where we're missing it, Rob. We're not focusing on the narrative. We're not focusing on tackles like this one here. Yeah. Oh, that's him.
That's because there's a slippery man.
Oh shit!
I was watching that presentation today, and I thought, you know, if there weren't tens of thousands of mugs, no one would be watching this.
Well, that's true. I mean, whether it turns into anything. I mean, we're saving the world. Is this guy saving the world?
Well, he's entertaining the planet, mate.
Yeah, that's how we're going to dance when we catch him.
Oh, yeah. Well, actually, why don't we – oh, is this why Richard wants his address? So we can give him Chavez's address. I'd love to know what that guy's saying.
You'll need to unlock your iPad first.
Oh, I don't want to hear you say anything.
A human truck.
Ooh, ow, that didn't work. I don't know.
I can tell you what he did wrong there. Because I used to be a rugby player. All right, you see someone that big coming at you, you let them roll straight over the top of you and you grab their legs.
Oh, okay. Good one, Rob. Let's see if somebody tries that in one of these videos.
Oh,
my God, they're pretty solid hits. Yeah, that's interesting. So
the only thing I tell is Mayberry or Brandon Envy.
What? Where is he? Have you got a link? Don't tease me.
No, Brandon's redoing his courses on what is a Bitcoin for $1,000. That's what the money's at there.
Actually, can we go visit Brandon? That will freak me out. I think I'll have a look while you guys are playing around doing nothing. Brandon.
Remember what we were talking about the other night about YouTube. You can't put anything up where anybody actually gets hurt. And you think, check that out.
This
trucking guy, the satellite phone.
Yeah, held it.
I got to stay on here, Rob. It's a family friendly show.
What? There's not these techno people.
Some of those big boys were as big as a truck. Would you like to drive them?
Yeah.
I know you miss me, Rob.
Do we? I don't think we do.
Rob did. I don't know about Danny.
Well, this is
Richard who? Richard who? This is Richard guy.
Rocker T.
Rocker Day baby.
Is this the evil guy in Summer Boo's room?
Well, I'll try. She loves me at the moment. Promise United. I thought I'd try. I don't know. Where's the guy? Where's our Brandon guy? What is the Toshi show? Dexter, Venn, Nene?
ICLA. ILCA. He's still promoting the step thing.
I've got.
And he did like a 50-minute presentation about the Novatech.
Oh, yeah. Well,
the big Rico case.
What about this one? Don't freak out, Rob.
If you were to name Alwyn Haynes, what do you think you're going to look like?
Jane Gregory.
If I'm gonna
big mustache him. Man. He should combine with Chavez. Big eyebrow man.
Yeah. You can have the hair group. Hairy man. There's nothing there. Everyone must be in bed sleeping, are they? Crypto tech. You miss Nandy's, poor old Nandy. This is Toshi.
Nandy comes back on the 17th for some reason. She must have ran out of scam money.
I was disappointed that she said she didn't know me because, you know.
Oh, you saw that we have Gobi's full presentation, right?
You don't. How did you get that?
Susie got that because Tammy's on the streaming platform, not the streaming platform, the same platform Mike and Mike are on. They upload their videos. And all you have to do is log in, make an account, and hit download.
Oh, my God. That's crazy. Oh, well, that's cool. So can I get a copy of that? And was it insightful? I mean, like, do we learn lots? Because that was amazing.
Insightful? Probably not. Can you get a copy insightful of that?
Insightful or exciting?
Copy? Yeah, hold on.
Yeah, I would love a copy of it because I'll just publish it and then it exposes them for what they're doing. It's essentially,
you know, I want to expose these bastards like the guy tackling people.
Do you? You could use a truck and you could just go in there and go, kaboom, I'm just going to run them over. And just,
got an email back from Wyoming.
Oh, yeah. Thank you for you. You're in the queue. You're number 4,991.
Yeah. No, look in the chat.
Hello, Richard. Can you park your delivery around the back? Third gate.
What chat? We're in WhatsApp, are we? Susie, what are you doing? Come on. Jump in here. I'll stop being silly.
Or Bill. Shenanigans. Bill. Help me. Bill.
Come on, Susie.
Yeah, diamonds in the making.
Come on, Susie.
And then speak to us in the room, and I'll stop being silly, and we'll share something decent. Like we'll go and find Richard
Daddy, in his window. Danny, not stop being silly.
I can't help but be silly. I just do it so naturally.
Now, Danny, did you record the Mike and Mike show or not?
Oh, I can give you the whole file, mate. Download the whole presentation. I don't think it's worthy. It was stupid, but yeah, I have got it. I've chopped it up into presentations.
You see, this is the whole thing. That's a person, that's a group that were promoting Boomerang.
That was a group that was promoting Boomerang.
Yeah, you got to think about it.
Mate, you think about this stuff? I marinate my brain cell in it, Rob. You know, it's more than thinking. I take it to another level. I'm actually above your level.
Pickle.
What?
Yeah.
Pickle. What'd you just say?
Pickle.
I'm just offering an alternative word for marinade.
I wonder what you're
doing. You're soaking it.
Have we got anyone listening
just
who
marinate
thinks
that for a while?
Have we got anyone in here that thinks that we may be? Can we have somebody new who wants to pop up on stage? You don't have to turn your camera on. Obviously, we've got those other two pussies below Rob and I that haven't got their camera on.
All right, the question is: have we got anyone listening? Full stop.
22 people. 22 people listening to us talking
about
nothing.
I'll turn my camera on for you.
No way.
Oh my goodness.
That's what we need.
Are you serious? I got to go back.
Look at
that.
Oh, wow.
There you go. Camera's on. Camera's off.
You've been out in the sun too long.
Camera's off.
Yeah. Well, I like the way he's got his hair at the moment. He's got more hair than you've got, Rob. You can see that.
I just need to get a pair of headphones for my avatar, and then I could be Rob.
We're still going to get the image approved of Rob.
Stay there. Hang on, though. Let me capture that one. Hang on.
Hey, I haven't looked at the traffic yet, but how many people do you think looked at our blog last night, Rob?
Excellent. Got it.
Oh, I haven't looked at that. Hold on. Have you looked?
No, I haven't.
Stop.
No, I haven't looked.
That's you.
I partially looked an hour after it went online. Do you want to have a guess how many people have looked at it?
I reckon it'll be 90.
Well, it could be. But let's say I govern it by how the first hour goes. And we actually had 33 people look at it in the first hour.
Oh,
so that's normally a really good
75.
Oh, the mother. What the hell's wrong with my audience? Are they good at life? It's like.
It's a shit thumbnail.
Well, I haven't updated it. Do you think I should put like a couple of hot chicks on there or something?
It's a crap thumbnail.
It's got you in it.
It's got bloody orange on there.
YouTube unscripted.
You might as well had two old men talk shit. In fact, no, that would probably be a step up.
What, a Dumber and Dumber?
No, because I'll see me on there and go, well, that's a misnomer.
Yeah, interview. But then if you do compare that to my other live, Summer Dunn. Hey, that's what we should do. We should give that to, we should give the link to Summer. She might want to come in here. She would be quite cool. Poor Summer, though. We've ruined her life, so she says.
However, back to Mike and Mike. Did you watch it? Have you actually played it on here?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, it was part of the, we can see who you were. Summer. I did invite Summer just now. She told me off. She sent me a screenshot telling me off.
Sorry about that.
In the screenshot, she gives me three of her friends' phone numbers. So then I said exposed by ChatGPT secret. I gave her a link to her web. This guy, the guy she is in the video with, Sam Lee, has been charged for a serious $4.9 billion scam. He was paying her rent in Dubai, and then I put a link to that. And then I sent it to the three people on her contacts. She's not quite that intelligent now, may some of it. And then she said, the best quote she said today, the best quote I've heard, I'm not as dumb as you think I am. So then I replied, well, how dumb are you then? Yeah. It's a charming comment.
Well, she sends you three of her friends' phone numbers.
But I text them all. They haven't wrote back to me yet. I have been getting some strange texts, though, lately. We had a guy basically tell me I shouldn't, I won't say the racial comment, but he basically said not to F with somebody. Oh, hold it.
Oh, no, we have united.
Wow, I've just stopped what I'm saying. Hello.
I'm going on.
Hi, Susie. How are you doing?
Hello.
Don't scare her off in the first sentence.
Oh my gosh. Wow. I feel so honored. Everybody's saying hello.
You are our only female Avenger, you know, so you are honored.
I think the top of one of my knees is vacant for you.
Oh, yeah. That right, he's got hairy kneecaps. And that's where he takes his excess hair from. It's all on his and back.
On so it's not a winky one.
Anyway, hello, Susie.
Thank Behave, you for coming. Boys.
Yeah, I know. Admiral, we're going to set the leadership.
Thank you, G.
Yeah. Well, we're listening to those noises. We're trying to figure out what
are we talking about?
What was
talking about? She's playing Super Mario World yesterday.
We're talking about you, Susie. That's why it went quiet when you come in the room.
Yes, Susie.
Yeah. Well, Rob was trying
to. I hope it was good.
Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah, it was the best conversation we've had all day. Rob was trying to figure out what the significance of Mike and Mike, what impact the Mike and Mike introducing a new arbitrage trading platform is going to have on the global market of Ponzi schemes. And I was trying to explain to him that it was dumber and dumber all over again. But they didn't.
No. You got the wrong angle. You've got a person who was really prominent in Boomerang, a crypto AI arbitrage trading tool, who's come out and said, here's another one that's actually already proven and is launching now.
He hasn't seen the screenshot.
Are you sure of this, Rob? Where did you get this information from?
Well, it's in the bloody email. So that's my angle, is that it wouldn't matter who, Mike and Mike were or how that presentation went. The sheer fact, it's very similar to a person like Joe actually running a meeting, and we get the recording of a Zoom meeting he's had for another arbitrage scheme. This is the same thing.
Yeah, bit different this one, because what I found funny is they actually had a screenshot of their what do they call it? I'll bring it up. But the screenshot of their WhatsApp group, and in their WhatsApp group, they actually literally had that's not the right
Boomerang.
One. Yeah, they had Boomerang and all the other. So they're not loyal.
Yeah.
That's the point, really.
It'd be nice to force the people that are having to watch that webinar to not be able to close their eyes a wink and have to keep their screens on and show them that they were promoting Boomerang less than 2 months ago.
Well, they're still actively doing it.
Look, Boomerang Rebels.
That's a video for it.
Wait a minute. They said right on the webinar that they have not Boomerang from their portfolio.
Did they say
they
that?
Said that?
Well, you listen.
They did.
I don't listen. I'm just one more theatrical. I'm waving my arms around. But you listen to that. Well done. I didn't hear that.
Did you say?
They have not eliminated it. They have not. Oh. They are still in Boomerang.
Oh my god! So they're not loyal.
So this is AI arbitrage diversification.
Well, they're not loyal.
It's not even arbitrage.
Oh, come
what
on.
What do you mean? Wash your mouth out.
Yeah, that's going to be positive.
Show me bubbles out your nostrils, Susie.
She's just been a FUD creator. She's
Let
just
me creating FUD.
It's a bit blurry, that image, Danny.
Oh, my God. So he didn't quite get the screenshot.
Quality, mate.
Rob, why?
Jesus, look at it. It's a screenshot of a live video in real time. There I am, look, trying to do a screenshot. At the same time, my screenshot.
Are you sure you're trying to do a screenshot and not a number two?
Before it disappears. Yeah.
Well, that was my. I actually went to the live broadcast on my own show in another tab and did a screenshot. It was actually a frigging crack up. I was quite proud of it, actually. And then I get the criticism coming in. I'm going to climb back under my rock. It's like.
Can't believe anybody would ever criticize you, Daniel.
Not too scared.
Rob Woolley.
Yes, Ricky.
Ricky.
I got a question for you, mate.
Oh, he's coming to visit us.
Yes, Ricky. Oh, hold on. What's the question, Dick?
Do you like Labatt Blue or Foster's?
Oh, he's going to play his
I'm sorry. I can't quite pick the accent.
Oh, okay. So let me ask my question, Mr. Rob Orlai. Would you rather that these scammers get busted by taking out these elderly home people leading Ponzi schemes in elderly homes? Or would you rather teach the younger people that these people?
Are you saying, what would you prefer, that I had you give them a fish or teach the younger folk how to fish?
Hello, Rob.
I'd like to see you and your rod and the size of your hook and tackle, and tell me what kind of bait you're gonna use, Dick.
Even he doesn't know how to answer that, Rob. Hey, have you had to speak another with an accent? Which one would you pick?
I'd pick Australian.
No, it's not Australian.
And then you got to do this.
Yeah.
How to that speak I. Australian.
I don't get on.
I'm from Sydney.
What part of Sydney, Danny?
I just I got a Holden Ute. I'm driving down the road. I look down the road about half okay, it's called Queensland.
I guess I could do Chinese. Or Spanish, and you just point.
Definitely gonna have to go back and capture a screenshot of that.
Here's a Chinese lady who's at Toastmasters, and she goes, "Hello, Labat. Labat, how you doing, Labat?"
Oh, that's Filipino.
I said, "Can you actually pronounce us?" Yeah, Labat.
Oh, no, Labat. I just got what you're saying. You're saying Robert. Yeah,
Labat.
What makes me? I don't know if you ever listened to X. What do they call it? X something or other. The singing show. And the Philippine people will come and rip off other people's songs and sing them with more vim and vigor than you've ever heard in your life. And then when they finish, right, they go back to their accents. And you go, how can you sing without an accent?
And a mate used to say that at school, eh? Yeah, you know, like you'd get some Scottish guy who would stand up there and go, blue eyes, Bieber's got blue eyes. And then they get interviewed later and they're going, I'm from fucking Glasgow and I've been sitting since I was 12. You know? And then when they sing, it's an American accent comes out.
Oh, what the hell's that? Somebody's gone on hold.
Ooh, Somerville.
Yeah. All right, so there you go. So we were worried about the impact that Mike and Mike might have on the boomerang industry and the significance of what happens, but it's just they're not loyal to anyone. They'll promote anything. And it's ironic. I did talk about it quite a few times when I did my video that Sharvisk was on their show, and then they invite, like, his worry opposition. So wonder if Sharvisk is going to say, yeah, I'll come back on your show again. Don't think so. Just saying. Because Sharvisk is so worried about it.
You've sold as many oranges as you can possibly sell. However, there's a batch of apples that are coming. And you
or maybe somebody should just drop them the clip, like, here's your boys. It's promoting somebody new.
Hey, Derek, we forgot to actually put your messages up. It's nice that you joined in the conversation. We'll just
see. Oh, my phone's off.
Here we go. And also, they talked about one funny thing that might interest you, Rob. They have a patent pending on the technology.
Yeah. Well, we haven't seen either actually launch.
Yes, did some of you? That Danny character, that was so cruel.
Yeah. I think he likes me.
When does
I always message him?
Try again, Rob. Susie's falling asleep.
When does the other one launch?
Well, it launched now, and I went in there and I got another error when I logged in before. So it's something
right,
wrong.
I can't work out if these people are actually making money. Any of these people, how come the tech, you know, like the visible tech, the websites and the social media is such
poor. Well, they all do the same. Probably it's all the same guy is doing it.
It would appear like that, eh?
Well, I do believe that's the case. I actually believe that these guys just rinse and repeat everything.
He's like, okay, you got 1 week to churn out another crappy website. Okay. Cut case.
Yeah.
I remember behind
you. All we need to see the same spelling mistakes, you know, or grammatical errors.
Yeah, but this time, green. Use green, red. Use multicolors. Okay.
Red. I remember when the Hyperverse created Hyperplanet. That was behind MLM. Actually managed to show that they had the same code. You know what I'm saying? Here you go. Now let's look at Happy Film. Now we can have a wee look. So let's have a look. So let's go log into my dashboard. This is me logging into
you
my dashboard.
You can sign up under Mike and Mike. You just signed up under Mike and Mike and really messed up the downline.
I already signed up. I was too quick. But this is my gold dashboard. I feel rich just looking at it.
Is this the other arbitrage game?
What I missed? Yes. I just came back.
We're looking at the arbitrage.
Just one lotto. Yeah. Did you not get the ticket?
$10,000 unlimited plan. Yes.
So I don't get this part. Why is there a daily per day payout rate if you do an arbitrage trading? Is this a guarantee?
Crypto G, you want to take that one?
I got to do arbitrage trading.
Do I have to?
Yes, okay. And you can explain what unstake yes means.
Unstake yes.
Yeah, it's got unstake yes.
Do you realize we've got two of the most intelligent people in the Avengers right here together? We can ask them any question that we like, and we'll probably get
You're talking about Bob and Vivian.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, give me a link. Derek wants a link.
They're going to have a conversation with themselves.
And we might have Derek coming on stage. He said, give me a link.
All right.
All right. We like visitors. You're welcome. Maybe you can explain this to us from a, I don't know, a layman's point of view. Well, we don't even know if you're a layman. You might be a government official, an IRS agent, or a Homeland Security.
Hold on. Let me go look around the cubicle.
Yeah.
Hey, he's standing up.
How is this supposed to work? You buy your license, and this thing actually pays you out 1.5% every day for the rest of your life.
Well, yeah. Engaging. It'll take you how long to earn back the 10 grand?
Yeah, well, 1.5% per day, that's 70 days. Well, that's not that long.
140 years, is it?
This is generational wealth, Crypto G. You've got to appreciate that a lot of people want to look out for their families and not really.
So, whose generational wealth is it?
Well, the guy that started.
Yeah. No, 143 days by the looks of it in that first standard plan, and about 70 days, just under 70 now days for the elite.
You know who the head cheese is already? It's the same guy who made FX Chain.
Hey, Josh, Hey, Josh, are you keen to talk on a mic?
Josh, you know what head cheese is, right?
Head cheese? What? That just
what happens when you click on the deposit button?
Oh, invest now, deposit. Where are we going? Deposit.
Yeah, I got X Bull Run already. Feeding me information.
For a deposit address.
Ooh, come on.
What should I use?
BTC. Yeah.
I think you should send 50 cents in.
No, 1/1,000,000th of a penny. See if there's a middle one.
A community of Vietnam.
0.0001.
You could go for a fishing amount.
And watch it works.
You ready?
Same flaw as the other one.
You never know.
Where did Rob go?
Whoa. It's our buddy.
Hello,
Shavis. Oh, Grace isn't here.
Hello, Shavis. How you doing, Shavis?
She's playing a video.
Yeah, they're just trying to inform their island community. They can hear us.
Oh, and you. And guess this: the X Bull Run admin is also in AMC. This Mike and Mike one. He's in the Telegram group.
Okay, I'll find out what it is. I'll just see.
David. Which is hilarious. That guy's booked me 6 times and still can't tell it's me.
Here we go. I'll stay in there anyway. So you want the wallet address, do you? Here we go.
Deposit.
Oh, so how will it work that out?
Oh, look at that.
Okay. There you go. Watch. Look, calm down. Calm down there, Crypto G.
Please do, exactly.
It might be a sweeper account, but, you know.
Yeah, what are we? Where do you want?
You never know.
Hey, why don't you get all the addresses? Get every single one.
Indeed, what a good idea.
All right. So, what have we got here? What are this called? We'll call it AMCD deposit. I can't even spell it. Hold up. Deposit. Did Rob just run away?
He's going live with the information.
Yeah. Oh, look, you took a screenshot of us there. There we go. So that's that. So now what do we do with that information? Get that there.
Yep.
And go, we can copy the address. And now we can just see we're still in here. Oh, look, we're still in here.
In token view. Yeah.
Yeah. Now we'll go to, they can see us, token view. Not these games.
She's working out. She's too busy to boot you.
You might not have booked Mark. Bookmarked.
Oh, I've been removed. Broken, boom. There's no love.
You say strucken, or stroken?
Wait, hey. Not that type of show, mate. Nothing there. So where else do I put now?
Token view.
Yeah.
Token view.
We can tell from the wallet address that it's a multi-sig. We can tell it's a multi-sig address. Does anybody know why?
So it's a multi-criminal one that they have to sign off on. That's great. So you can make sure that your criminal partner is not cheating.
Yeah. If a Bitcoin address starts with 3, it suggests that it's a multi-sig wallet.
Yep.
Ding.
Ding.
Dong.
You want to make? You think they're all going to be multi-sig?
It's a good chance that we might get a lead from it if it is a multi-sig. It's the BSC and all, you know, the other network ones. They tend to use sweepers, and if it's not had any money in it, then it's difficult to find the trail. There's no link, but I guess if you stuck a couple of dollars in there, that might. Sometimes you have to invest to find out. That's why we need some funding, you know. That would help.
I think we just crashed. Here, we did crash.
Somebody did.
I was wondering, just me and Crypto G. I was like, Danny disappeared.
Glad you guys came to door.
It was quite pleasant.
We got the, you know,
for a few minutes.
Like Crypto G is taking over the stage, huh?
Well, I was trying to get him a crypto wallet, and that didn't work. And then where do I usually put it into something, and I put it into here.
If you could send a millionth of a penny, like the mark technique 0000001 generate, because I bet you would glitch, just like on every other one. Until Boomerang figured it out. I bet you it's the same glitch.
Okay.
And he crashed it
again. It's he's obviously, he's maxing out, isn't he, Bob? He's maxing out everything.
It's that wallet. It's that wallet connected to too much Bitcoin power.
But his YouTube stayed live. Is that, it'd be interesting to see. looks like.
Yeah, no, I don't get that. Why would...
is it? I don't know. I'm looking at StreamYard, aren't I? So what's happening?
So StreamYard is still going, but I wonder.
Yeah, no, it's still going. Yeah, it is. It's still live on YouTube. That's weird.
But Danny's crashed. That's weird.
Yeah.
So I guess StreamYard has some delay built in. I wonder how long would it go.
There's definitely a delay on between that and YouTube, but my area of expertise.
He tried to come back.
Come on, Danny.
working on it.
Oh, Danny boy.
That sound again?
Yeah, you got that. Time,
I changed web browser.
Yeah, every time you try and fire up Zoom. Is it?
No, it's Crypto G. Can you hear me?
It's because I'm using Firefox.
Yeah. Can you, Rich?
Welcome back.
Emailed Wyoming.
And how are they?
They said, we have received your email and we'll be taking a look into it. Can you confirm the name of the DAO as registered in Wyoming? That's like the coolest news we've ever heard.
Yeah, they must be getting pissed off with people sending. It's like, have you seen Shawshank Redemption? He keeps sending a letter every day to stock the library up. And when they actually send him what he asked for, he says he's going to write two letters a day from now on.
Right.
We need to step up the frequency. Just keep spamming them.
That's why I put Crime Stoppers in there. Imagine that we got 6, 7, 8 states.
Oh, they showed up in this special room.
105 people. Do you think Crypto Maxi Pad will stay in there for long?
We've lost that? Susie.
That's my username. Crypto Maxi Pad.
Susie.
My name.
The best.
Oh, I got removed from the meeting.
Danny, you got to change my name, dude. Why you got my name on the screen?
Well, do you not want your name on there? All of a sudden, you want
to
hide your name.
No, you go into WhatsApp and change my name to the code name, dude.
Oh, right. You see that?
Trucking. His name is Trucking.
Did Susie and Rob disappear at the same time? Did Susie and Rob disappear at the same time? Where have they snuck off to?
Here we go. Oh my gosh. I feel so bad for Grace. I think she's going to croak at any minute.
Well,
I think you scared her off, Admiral.
Make sure you send her the podcast. You know.
Yeah. Oh my god! Dude, who wants to see this crap?
They give us space to.
Oh, wait. I have to read my disclaimer.
Chat next time.
You cannot rebroadcast my show. But I break terms of service by showing you this stuff, and I like to gray out stuff because it's copied probably from somewhere else. We are all Satoshi. Thank you. That's our disclaimer. They all do that now. You see that? They all do disclaimers now.
Seek guidance from a qualified professional. Attendees accept these terms by continuing. Let's explore affiliate marketing cautiously.
So what if I come in late and I don't see the
disclaimer? You are viewing a We're All Satoshi official presentation on affiliate marketing model 2.0.
I was drunk when I saw the disclaimer. I didn't see nothing.
Their component parts and operating methods and systems either provided by or created by We're All Satoshi belong solely to We're All Satoshi. All IPs are protected.
Is this anyone copying,
distributing,
or reselling?
Did you just say all IPs are protected?
Yeah, that's not funny. So there we go. Lost that one. Well, that was good while it lasted, though. Where were we going? We're going to websites.
You should get a piece of paper and then write up Grace's, but you can't broadcast it, but it's that you should just hold up Grace.
I want your babies. I want your babies. Yeah, so that was short-lived, but I don't need to go in there today, kids, so that's why I was being silly. But they'll report me now. They'll report me to their version of sect, but the other side of, what's the opposite to sect? It's like you must have an organization where you can be a scammer and report, you know, is it the black web? You report Danny to the black web.
Your back office of the dark web.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, back on. Report Danny. Winston Chinese hands.
Wisconsin cheeseheads.
Cheese heads. Cheeseheads.
Right. Your license of your teeth, your comments, and your nature.
Your comments.
Yeah, it's called the Danny license. We keep on trucking.
I was quite impressed that old
Bob license gives you like 6x.
Where did we find anything? Now, where did I? So I got go back here and I go to the deposit address, right?
Yeah, and just grab all of them.
What do you mean, all of them?
Well, there's different coins you could deposit into, right?
Oh, I see. But which one would most people use?
USDT. Yeah, probably USDT. I think that's the one we just grabbed, didn't we? No, we got Bitcoin.
That one there, isn't it?
Okay. Dodge? They're taking Dodge?
Really?
I'm excited.
That's an odd one. I don't know who would deposit Dodge.
So when you think about it, this, you know, theoretically, I'll make a list of them. Theoretically, you know, these guys could just take the money, right?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, well, that's crazy, isn't it? You know, they could just never deliver anything, and just, you know, this is just a fake.
It's the first rule. It's the first rule, isn't it? Don't send your assets to anyone else's wallet unless you know them and there's good reason.
The first rule is to promote a product that does not exist.
That's from the other side. That's from the other side. Yeah.
My copy and paste won't work. Oh, look. So we just have to go back and go through all of them one at a time, do we?
Your what doesn't work?
And then we're going to deposit 0000001.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, minimum deposit is $49.
Is it? Yeah.
Well, where did Rob go?
Oh, he ran away because I went on live. He freaks out.
So the minute, like, why would you pick 49? That's a weird number.
Yeah. Oh,
Rob Woolley.
Oh, that's a longer address.
Rob Woolley of Switzerland.
Probably come back no more.
I mean, 10 makes, like, Boomerang's 10 makes a little sense, but 49, that's weird.
It doesn't actually acknowledge that I've clicked that box. Oh, no, it does. So what's 49? What are you
talking about?
500? 5,000?
Didn't you do BBC already?
Once you've got the deposit address, you can send however much you want.
Yeah, true. That's just disgusting, then, isn't it? The fact that, yeah, you're right. There must be a quicker way of doing this. Do you think Grace enjoyed seeing me today? I reckon I'll make a day when she sees me.
I think when she sees you.
You reckon?
She thinks she's got curry in her eye.
Curry.
You send her the podcast yet?
You ever had curry in your eye?
What was that, mate?
You gotta send her the podcast. You know, you gotta copy the part when you mention her name and send her that part.
I should love that. Reruns of Grace and Danny show. I mean, that's gonna be the best of. You don't need me to tell you what thingies these are, do I? Do you like my pigeon way of doing this? There probably is a whole list of them written on the About Us page, isn't there?
Certain people do that.
But this is just the worst of the worst.
You can see if they have any talent by doing that. I mean, even crappy Boomerang promoter put those together. So was that error, sorry?
I don't change the price I did last time. It comes up with an error. This just shows you bad coding all around, doesn't it? Do you know what I mean? So you watch
that. Yeah, so it doesn't even check the value, it looks like. It just.
Yeah, that's exactly it. So I'm just.
So if you leave 49 in there, like, or the same number in there, it gives you an error?
I hit the back button.
Okay. What's
the point of the name?
What's the name? And then I just leave it as it is and go submit.
What's the point of the name?
Aquamarine? I have no idea.
Above my pay scale, that's the question there, Crypto G.
They were running out of names and stuff, so they're like, somebody's like, "Oh, I need water."
It does seem a bit random, doesn't it?
Aquamarine. So can you go into these wallets and see how much money they've got?
They're selling boats. Yeah, possibly. It depends what.
Well, what's the weirder is there's a dude in Mike and Mike's that has like a, it's a real name of a benefits company. So I'm like, is this guy an idiot? And he joined like, just like the other, like, who was that lady? Keith Ralstone, who joined from a lawyer's office, who involved in fraud. How about that one? Yeah. There's a Netflix theory right there. I'm committing fraud at a lawyer who investigates fraud.
I've got a video that I should play. We should actually end this, and I've got a video I should play because I've got a mate of mine, Jim. You know Jim, he's been in here. He's put together a case. He reckons he's got a thingy. So, which I'll do. I'll just, what have we got here? So we've got deposit.
We got any more comments from our fans that need answers?
Really, we might call this one. What I'll do is I'm just going to shut the meeting off, and then I'm going to play you guys a video, which might be quite interesting for you, and see what you think.
Is it?
Hey, Danny.
Yo, bro.
One cool thing that you could show the audience is
I also sent you the Vim. You got the Gobi video, right?
Just let Bob over talk you there, Richard. Don't you worry.
Yes, I did it. No,
it's like that, isn't it? It's like he just starts talking. It's like a freight train.
You've got to try and find the space, haven't you?
Make a sound. Make a 2-3 minute sound clip of how you took down David the other day to end the show with. That's awesome.
What David?
The David, remember how he's like, I'm not doing this with you anymore. If you want to be part of the MLM, go find somebody else.
Oh, yeah.
Like the highlights. Make a good clip of then you can close out the call with like the final 2 minutes of it.
Cool.
I want to join under Carl though. And then I could like join all these meetings. That's where we got to go tomorrow. Working with Carl.
All right. Well, let's. I'll end the official meeting on that so we can end this. And then I want to play a video to you. So let's go to my shorts.
You got the Gobi video, right?
I've got every video, mate. You've just got so much data. I don't get to sleep at night anymore. Life is gone. Share screen. Window.
Well, you got backsync them to Odyssey.
But mate, I've got it backed up on 8 different platforms. I'm streaming right now on through 6 different platforms because 2 of them have fallen off because I've been going for more than 4 hours. So, yeah. So, we get it. Right. So, here we go. So, ready. Oh, did I not? Oh, I didn't do that. No. I haven't uploaded the short. Well, in that case, I have to go to the video.
I might well watch it from a distance, Admiral.
From a distance, and then
do you need me for any more information on the back end?
I do actually. Hey, we're just what I'll do. Hold it.
Our buddy Carl. Right. I should give him a ring.
I did have one.
Carl, not David.
Cleaning up some stuff.
You have to try and grab your moments.
Let's go through it. What is that? One.
Hold it.
Perhaps I need to be more forceful and say that.
What?
Does that work if I get right up on the microphone? Do I manage to secure a few moments of mic time?
Right there.
Mic time.
That's good, mate.
Some are done.
If he made it to the top rank in Hyperfund, how in hell did he not make money? He said that he lost money in that program. If he was VIP 5, how the hell did he not make an upside?
He wasn't on VIP. I think he was up there. I don't think he was VIP 5.
He said he made it to the top rank.
We have all the VIP 5 numbers. Unless he changed his number after that whole fiasco.
So he's either lying that he didn't get to the top rank, or he's lying that he didn't make
multiple aliases
money.
Oh my god! So we've got this Roby opportunity announcement free thing.
I bet he's got multiple aliases.
So what's this meeting that you've given me for Vimeo? Is that another meeting then promoting this new opportunity?
Yeah, go look. You might notice a few people in there.
Oh, hell yeah.
How do we access all that, Bill? Because I bet they have been in there.
Well, you take the link, then you hit follow Tammy Jackson, and every time she posts a video, you go, okay. Thank you.
You're calling for the toilet.
All right, guys. So we've got some good intel coming in here. I'm just gonna end this. I want to play a quick video, and I just want to say,
everybody off the stage, but Bob, thank you.
Right, just stay here for a second. We're just going to call a quick meeting. We've got a private meeting going on, and we use StreamYard, so we don't have anyone peeping in and seeing what we're doing. So we're just going to end the meeting. Thanks for watching the live. I'll try to break this into some meetings, and we'll see you in the next meeting, which will be 6 a.m. tomorrow morning. See you guys.